Hello everyone, welcome to another video, Dusty here. In today's video, I'm going to give you a full rundown and tutorial showing you how to get set up and start using Google Calendar. Even if you are just starting with Google Calendar as your new calendar system, or if you've been using it for a while and looking for some tips and pointers on how to better utilize and use it more efficiently, this is the video for you. I'm going to try to cut out as much fluff as possible, but also give you all of the bells and whistles and all of the full details of how to add events, how to share calendars, how to do all of the things that you're going to want to do with the calendar system this day and age. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing you've got to do, obviously, is log into your Google account. So when you log into your Google account, you're going to see your icon in the upper right hand corner, whether you're utilizing Gmail. So if you use the little icons up here, you can see you can access YouTube, Gmail, Calendar. But again, on your account, you need to go to google.com or just Google, right? Google account and sign up for a Google account if you don't already have one, but you probably do if you're watching this video. So just wanted to cover those bases there. Make sure you're logged in and you are at the Google Calendar page. You can go to calendar.google.com and that'll take you directly to your native calendar. Now, I'm going to go over the UI just a little bit here before I dive into the actual nuts and bolts of how to use the actual calendar. So on the left-hand side here, you're going to see an kind of a bird's eye view here of the month that you are in. So if we hit these arrows right and left, we can quickly browse our months here in the year that we're in. And then you can go as far forward or as far backward as you want. Down below, we're going to see our calendars here. Any calendar that I have created or added from the Google suite of calendars will be here under my calendars. And then under other calendars, these are ones that I've added, and I'll show you how to do that very shortly from the list or the suite of calendars that Google has built in. So again, you can click the arrow here to minimize or maximize to see all of them, and then you can check or uncheck them if you want to actually see the events or the actual calendar events on the actual calendar. So if I uncheck this one here, my main calendar, you can see all of the blue text goes away, or the blue highlighted text goes away. That is because I have decided to deselect that calendar, and anything that is within that calendar will be removed. And speaking of the color coding here, I normally like to keep mine different colors just so I know what is what. So my wedding calendar here, I do wedding videography, will obviously be a green color. So this dark green over here on the 30th, the Saturday, March 30th, you can see that event is on the wedding calendar. So if I unselect or deselect that, that will be removed. This is great for if you just want to see things in a particular calendar. You can deselect everything here, and as you can see, everything will be removed except for the calendar that you leave checked. So again, that's kind of how all of that works there on the left-hand side. The main screen here is going to be your calendar. I should say this, by the way, everything I'm showing you on desktop will be very similar on mobile as of recording of this video. The only difference is the default input will be obviously you touching your screen as opposed to clicking the mouse. That shouldn't have to be said, but again, I'll have someone in the comments say, well, you told me it's going to be the same on mobile. Not exactly, but it is very similar. So let's dive into it here. On the upper right hand of your screen there, you're going to see a drop down that says month, day, week, year, schedule. Now, this is going to be how you view your calendar. Now, if I want to view my calendar weekly, I click the weekly option here and I can see a better breakdown of this week. So let's say it's Monday morning. I want to see what's going on this week. I can go hit that drop down menu there, select week just like this, or hit the W key on my keyboard, and that'll take me to the week view. This can show me exactly the times of different things that are going to be happening. I can scroll the different weeks here. So let's just say I want to go to March. So here we are. Let's go to this week in March. As you can see, coming up in a few hours, I do have an event, and it lets me know the time that it starts. It lets me know what calendar it's on. Any event that is going to be an all-day event will be at the top of the week there. And then if you want to, you can even go to a day view. And if you have a whole bunch of events or calendars or appointments, those will be listed here, and you can see your full day breakdown just like this here. Now, if we go to schedule, now schedule basically is not going to show you any days that have no events or no, I guess you would say appointments on them. Basically, it's going to show you every single thing you have in all of your calendars in basically a bullet style list. So where you can go in, see what calendar, see what time, and see what day all of those events are. Now, I rarely use that actual viewpoint. I normally love to use the month viewpoint or the weekly viewpoint just so I can see everything in the grand scheme of things. But that's how you change how you view. Now, if you want to search your calendar and you're like, I knew I had something coming up, but I have no idea what day or what week I set that for, click the search tab here and you can search it. So let's say I want to search for that wedding that I have coming up. If I go here, search for it, it comes up March 30th. It's an all-day event and you can search just like you would within any other software or in Google. And then when you're ready to go, click the back arrow here to get directly back to your calendar. Now, let's talk about the fun stuff, right? How do I add events to a day on my calendar? So let's say you have something coming up on the 26th of March, okay, 2019. Obviously, if you're watching this in the future, apply the date that's applicable for this time of you watching the video. Double click, okay, within that specific day. So go to the day, double click. Now, again, you can, if we go back here, you can single click on the day and have a kind of a tab come up to add it really quickly. But honestly, I recommend you double clicking because you can get to where you can have more details. Now, if you just want to add something really quick, something came up, you can single click and do it that way. But I recommend you double clicking and then go ahead and type in what it is. So let's say appointment one. Okay. And the appointment is not going to be all day. Now, if the appointment is going to be all day, click the check mark here by all day. Normally, by default, that is selected. By that, you're going to see something that says does not repeat. Now, this is where you get into the nitty gritty of things that are going to be repeating on your calendar. Let's say you want to put your workouts, or you know, you're trying to work out Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Basically, what you can do here is you can go to right here where it says does not repeat, select the drop-down menu. Now, some are very simply. Are very simple. You can click here if it's going to be weekly on Tuesday, if this event's going to happen every Tuesday, if it's going to happen monthly on the fourth Tuesday of every month, annually on March 26th, like a birthday, every weekday, Monday to Friday. It gives you a couple of examples here, but if you want to customize exactly when this event is going to repeat, click the custom tab here, and you're going to see here this little box come available to you. You want this to repeat every 1 week, so you want it to be weekly. You want it to repeat on, say, Mondays, or let's say Tuesdays and Thursdays. You want it to repeat on Tuesday and Thursday, and when do you want it to end? Do you want it to end never? You want it to keep going? You want to continue to work out? Or do you want it to end at the end of the year? So go all the way to, say, December 2019, December 31st, it'll end at the end of the year, okay? Or you can say, oh, I've got 6 appointments that I need to do. I want it to be, you know, go down to the 6 number here, and then after 6 times on the calendar, it will end. Or you can just choose never and you're good to go. So you want it to repeat weekly, or you can do monthly, yearly, or daily. And then once you've done that and you've selected when you want it to end, the days you want it to repeat on, click done. And then you can see here it's going to be weekly on Tuesday and Thursday. Now, if you want to add a location, this is great for businesses like mine who, you know, do wedding videography or things like that. You can add a location. That way you can have an address to pull up on your phone to, if you're very bad at geography like I am and you need a GPS everywhere you go, which is something that I'm trying to get away from, you can add a location here to make it much easier. Now, add conferencing, just ignore that here. I have installed an app, a Zoom app, and I'll show you how to install different apps to add to your Google Calendar at the end of this video. So stick around for that if you want to know how to do that. Underneath add notification, do you want to be notified? Is this something you need to be reminded about? Normally, I'm looking at my calendar rather frequently, so I normally don't do notifications, but if you want to be notified, and Google will send you an email, it'll notify you. I want to be notified one day before at 9 a.m. And then it'll send you a notification saying, hey, you've got an event coming up this time, this day. Basically, that's it. And you can add another notification if you're like some people who need alarm clocks like 5 or 6 times during the morning. Maybe you need to set up multiple notifications, but I don't know. Maybe you don't. The next thing here is the calendar that you want to add it to. Now, if you're new to Google Calendar, you probably only have one calendar. But if you have multiple calendars, select the drop-down menu, select the different calendar that you want to add it to, and then select the highlighted color. Normally, I leave the color to the native calendar color. It just makes it easy. Underneath this here, do you want to be shown as free or busy? Now, this is if you're setting up appointments with other people throughout the week, throughout the days. If you put busy here, which you probably want to do if you have an event or an appointment, you can see here that this is going to be public for people to see. Anyone who is sharing this calendar or looking at this calendar will be able to see that you are busy if you change this to public. Now, if the default is public, but if you want that to be private, you can change that here as well. Under description, write down whatever you want to put here, describe the event or appointment that you're setting up. And then the last thing I'm going to show you is probably the biggest thing here on events is going to be guests. So if you want to include or invite people so they can have this on their calendar, which by the way, this will add the event on any calendar. It doesn't have to be Google Calendar or GCal. It can be iCal, it can be Windows Cal, whatever they're using. This will basically just give them a notification or an ability to add this to their specific calendar that they are using. So under add guest here, we can go here and we can see that we have different people. So if I want to add, let's say I want to add Andrew to my event here or appointment, I can just go and search by email there and do it that way. Or you can type in a brand new email here if you want to do that as well. Now, the thing that I'm going to do here is when I click save, it's going to ask me, would you like to send invitation emails to Google Calendar guest? Okay, so if I hit send here, that's going to notify Andrew that I've added him to an event. Would he like to add this to his calendar? Okay, that's something that's very important. Now, if you don't want to send it, or if they've requested that you don't give them any type of notifications, then you just put don't send, or you just hit cancel changes. That's really up to you. I'm going to go ahead and hit don't send because I do not want him to get that. Now, as you see here, if I scroll down different months here on my calendar, you can see every Tuesday, every Thursday for the foreseeable future, actually forever, because I didn't select an end date, there's going to be that appointment. Now, how do I go and edit an appointment or an event after it's already been added? Very simple. Select one of the appointments or events, just click on it here. You can do it here within the direct box, or you can double click. That'll take you directly back to this here. Now, how do we delete this event? Basically, what we do is we go to More Actions up here in the drop-down menu in the center of the screen, and then go here where you see Duplicate, Delete, Print. Click the Delete button. It'll ask you, do you want to delete the recurring event, or maybe it's just stopped for this particular day and week? What I recommend you do is go to All Events. If you want to remove the entire event, click OK. Go ahead. Would you like to send the cancellation emails to the guest on this event? Which again, that really is dependent for you. You can enter an optional message as for why you're canceling and then hit send. That will cancel that particular event and all of the ones in the future. All right. Now let's talk about what you do if you want to actually go back and add someone to an event. Very simple. You go here, you double click on the event. You go here, you can see I have two guests, two confirmed guests, by the way. If they've confirmed it, you'll see a check, green check mark by their name, but you can always go back at a later date and add guest directly here from the format page within the event settings. Basically, that's it. And then you just hit save and you're good to go. Couple of things that you can do within the event other than what we've done here is go to More Actions. You can print the event. You can duplicate it to other days. You can copy it to different calendars. You can publish the event to a public calendar, or you can even change the owner. Very rarely would you do any of that, but if you want to, you definitely can. Now, let's talk about calendars themselves. Let's say you have a team and you want to create a calendar for your team to share that you all can see and you all can look at any given time. If that's something you want to do, underneath the bird's eye view here, you're going to see something that says add calendar. If we click the three dots here, we're going to see a couple of different options. We can create a new calendar, which is what I just mentioned. We can browse calendars of interest, which we'll get into that shortly, from a URL. If someone said, hey, I've already created our team calendar, here's the link for that, and I'll show you how to populate that link yourself. You can do that from URL. Or if we click on import, we can even bring other people. This is very important for people coming from, say, iCal, Outlook, other calendars. You can go here and import from a file and bring your calendar and events and settings directly into Google Calendar very, very easily and efficiently. Now, if we click the three dots again and we go to create a new calendar, this is where all of the magic happens, okay? So we're going to create a new calendar now, and we're going to call it Calendar 2 Tut for tutorial. We're going to give it a description, bunch of different words there if you want to, and the time zone here, whatever native time zone that you are in and that you use. Google's pretty good about changing and manipulating the time zone, so I would just use the one that you're currently living in. It makes it much simpler for you when you're setting up appointments and events. And then when you're ready, click the button here that says create calendar. Now, once it creates, once it's done, it'll say calendar 2 successfully created here at the bottom. You'll see it over here on your settings. Now, if you want to change settings for one of your current calendars, you can just select them here under settings and then access permissions, share with specific people. Again, you can go here once you've created your calendar and basically change all of these things. We can add people to the calendar. like say your team members. You can give event notifications as far as a template for events. You can add all day event notifications. You can give general notifications. You can basically change all of the back end things with your calendar directly from the settings here. Now, if you want to integrate your calendar, you'll have a calendar ID. You'll have a public URL to this calendar. It'll have access for people to view the calendar, but not to add and things like that. There's so many things you can do here. I'm not going to go over all of them, but if you have any questions about anyone in particular, put those comments in the section below this video, and I'll try to help you out the best way I know possible. Now, if you want to share a calendar, okay, basically what you would do is you would take that link from that page we were just at and send that to your team member, and you would be good to go. Now, if we want to delete a calendar, go to the options here, go to create new calendar again to get to this page, and then go to the calendar that you've created that you want to delete, and then basically all you're going to do here is basically here at the bottom, you're going to see something that says remove calendar. Click remove calendar here. And then when you're ready to go, click the delete button. It's at the very bottom. It'll say, are you sure you want to permanently delete this calendar? Click permanently delete and you are good to go. So that's the basics of Google Calendar. Now, if you want to get into the more, I guess you would say intermediate or advanced things, you can add different apps to Google Calendar. So if we go over here to this actual addition symbol here, it says get add-ons. If we go to that, I've already have Zoom for Google Calendar added. You can add GoToMeeting. You can add other conferencing suites and things like that. We can go down to productivity, search for apps that are related to creative tools here. And again, if there is a app for the calendar that basically works with Google Calendar, it'll be here. And you can go here and select that, and you can just install it like you would within Gmail and tools that you're using within that suite as well. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Hopefully it was helpful. If it was, put down below the questions that may arise when you're watching this video. Don't forget to share with people who you think could find this content useful, and I will see you guys in the next one.